Kitchen. I'm Sarah.
Hi, I'm Rose.
And today we're here with another awesome episode. We're continuing on with Macro October. And so in the spirit of Macro October, we have a macro balanced dinner.
We certainly do. And this is our one pan veggie lamb roast. So what we're going to do is obviously just use one pan. Nice, simple and easy to show you how to make a macro balanced meal.
So the beauty of this recipe is it's really easy because it's in one pan, and it's really easy to get a lot of different vegetables in there, really easy to get a lot of variety in there,
yep.
And you can do it midweek because you just put it all in one pan and pop it in the oven. It's so good.
That's it. And it's all finished within about 30 minutes. And we're actually going to have 5 different veggies today. So we thought we'd really bump up the veggie intake, really increase that fiber, the phytonutrients, and all the other beautiful nutrients and minerals found in these lovely vegetables. So we will start.
We're just going to drizzle a bit of olive oil on the pan to start off. You could also use coconut oil if you wanted, depending on the flavour, although I think olive oil does go nicely with lamb.
Yes.
So then we've just got these little lamb medallions here. I'm just going to pop on, this recipe serves 2, so we've got 2 of the lamb medallions there.
Yep.
And that of course is our protein and our fat.
It certainly is. And now we have got some pumpkin. And then we're just going to arrange pretty much the pumpkin around. I'm just going to spread some of this oil on the tray. And just enough pumpkin for 2 serves. So we've got, that's about it. And as we all know, pumpkin is a starchy carbohydrate. And it also has beta-carotene, which is your vitamin A.
Yes, and great source of fiber as well.
Yes.
So with pumpkin, because it is your starchy carb, you don't actually need as much as the other vegetables. So here we've probably got like 2 fists worth, and that's probably fine.
Yeah.
For 2 people.
That's it. Exactly. All right, then we've just got some zucchini, and we've actually got zucchini and squash. And an interesting thing, I'm not sure if you know, but zucchini and squash, well, yellow squash, are both in the same family, which are summer squashes. So
that's a pretty cool fact.
Yeah. And if you actually look up squashes, there is so many different types of squashes and shapes and sizes. So this one is kind of this little pretty shape here, but then you can get kind of, you know, the long yellow squashes, which is a similar shape to the zucchini as well. And these are a great source of fiber as well.
Yeah, vitamin C, potassium, all your good stuff. So you can be a bit more generous with these types of veggies because they're not your starchy ones, so not as high in calories. And so then, yeah, we've just arranged them on the corner there. And another good way, actually, when you're looking at arranging the pan, you could even do like corners. So if you've got like 4 different vegetables, you can just put 1 in each corner.
Yeah,
that's another way to measure it out.
Super easy. And obviously we've got something of all the different colors as well.
Yes, which we love to do. We've watched this show for a while, we always carry on about that. But there's reasons for that. So we've also got some beetroot. Our beetroot is high in nitric oxide, which is a component that's actually a vasodilator. Now what this means is it actually dilates the blood vessels, which allows blood to pass through more freely. So really good if you've got any problems with hypertension or high blood pressure, anything like that. That's really going to help with blood circulation, also poor circulation as well.
Yeah.
Yeah, really
and
good.
And if you even look at beetroot, so for example, here we go, it actually looks like the shape of a heart. And when you juice beetroot and the colour of beetroot is red, it looks like blood. So this is an excellent vegetable that actually looks like what it actually has in the body. And if you have a look then at the stem of the beetroot, that's kind of like the veins, you know, and that come out, the circulation, you know, that comes out of the heart. So if you kind of have a look at it.
Pretty cool, right?
It is pretty, it is so
nature.
Awesome.
Nature.
I know,
sorry,
it really
so intelligent.
Is. Yeah, so that's kind of, you know, the veins and the capillaries there. And with the beetroot, we don't want to just use the bulb of the beetroot. We can also use the stem and the leaves. So don't throw these in the bin. They are an excellent source of protein. You've also got, you know, lots of vitamins and minerals as well in here as well. So what we just do, just rip some of them up.
Great source of iron.
Yes. Mm. And we're just going to...
just pop a few over. And then the last one we've got is asparagus.
Oh, yes.
Good old asparagus.
Asparagus. Here we go. And asparagus is a prebiotic.
Yes, it is. Yeah.
Which is excellent to feed your gut bugs.
Yes.
So our gut absolutely loves prebiotics because the prebiotic is their source of food.
Yep. So great microbiome enhancing food, asparagus. Yes. Also very good for your liver because they contain sulfur, which helps the liver to detoxify.
And also an excellent source of fiber. So we do have a lot of fiber-rich foods here, which we always want in our diet to help regulate our bowels as well.
Yep. But if you're not used to eating this amount of fiber, definitely make sure you increase your water and increase your fiber intake slowly. So if you don't eat a lot of fiber generally, increase slowly because it can sort of play a bit funny with your bowels if you increase it too quickly and if you don't also increase water.
Yeah, that's a very, very good point. Then we're just going to season it with some salt and pepper. And that's it. That is how quick and easy it is. That probably took us about 5 minutes.
Yep.
And here we go. This is absolutely delicious, ready to pop in the oven, and then we'll be back once it's cooked.
All right, welcome back. So we've just had this in the oven at 200 degrees for about 30 minutes, and now we've pulled it out and it's ready to go.
It is. So simply, we're just going to serve.
So we'll just get one lamb medallion and just pop it on the plate like so.
Yep.
We're going to add some asparagus on there. Now when you're building your plate, what you want to do is you want to have about half of the plate your non-starchy vegetables. So that's going to be like your asparagus and your zucchini, squash and beetroot in this case, and the beetroot leaves. And then you want to add, a quarter of your plate protein, which is the lamb that we've got there. And then finally, we're just adding your starch portion. So in this case, it's the pumpkin.
That's it, and that is as easy and simple as it is. So I'll just add,
don't forget squash.
Squash, yum.
Don't forget squash.
And we're just gonna add a bit more beetroot as well because we want a little bit more color on the plate. So in previous episodes, we've always talked about the balanced plate, exactly as Sarah said, quarter protein, quarter carbohydrates, and then we want half of the non-starchy vegetables.
Yeah, so here we've got our macro-balanced dinner. We've got protein, fat in the lamb, and then we've got our carbohydrates and all the veggies. And then all we're going to do, we're actually just going to sprinkle some sesame seeds on top.
Yes.
Now, sesame seeds are... well, they look great for starters. It just looks so pretty when you sprinkle them over the top. But they're actually a really nutrient dense little food. So they've got calcium, zinc, magnesium, folate, B3. Am I missing anything?
I think that's about it.
They're
a little superfood and they are super delicious. So all you do is, you can either sprinkle them on your roast vegetables, you can even add like a tablespoon to a porridge, you can add them to energy balls. They can, when they're ground down, they make the tahini paste as well, and even a dollop of tahini on that for your good healthy fats. Heaps of different ways of eating the sesame seeds. Very versatile, and as we mentioned, very nutrient dense.
Yes. So that's about it. Please let us know what you think of this recipe in the comments below, and if you make it, let us know. We'd love to hear about it. And give this video a like if you enjoyed this episode, and subscribe to the channel. If you're in the Facebook group, you'll receive the recipe shortly. If you'd like to join the group, the link to the Facebook group, the Gut Kitchen Members Hub, is in the description below the video. But otherwise, that's it.
Yeah, until next week. We'll see you then.
See you later.